Director Salvi Patron, Mr. Izuru Kobayashi, Professor Peter Drysdale, distinguished guests, representatives from the academe, government, civil society, private sector, and media, my fellow civil servants, welcome and a pleasant morning to you all. The PIDS is proud to co-organize this public symposium with Korea as part of our contribution to the celebration of the ASEAN's 50th founding anniversary this year. This gathering is actually our second time to co-sponsor the celebration of the ASEAN's 50th founding anniversary, and we did that last month with RIA and the Mindanao Development Authority in Davao. Specifically, the symposium was aimed at understanding the socio-cultural community vision of ASEAN that was a celebration in Davao. It took a deeper look into the issues and challenges in strengthening the socio-cultural ties that bind the ASEAN member states. The Davao symposium had us frame the ASEAN socio-cultural pillar. This time, we are gathered to discuss another pillar, and an equally important one, the ASEAN Economic Community. The AEC was formally established in late 2015, and it's now timely to examine what has been accomplished, and more especially, to address the challenges that continue to confront us in building a truly integrated and inclusive economic community. The AEC has a number of bright spots that indicate its great potential to be a major driver of global growth and development. And we are fully aware of this. A big, robust market of 600 million people, the availability of a young and talented labor force, and healthy investment climate that is underpinned by move toward competitive markets. Additionally, the strong commitment of the political leadership to a vibrant AEC should be emphasized. As an integrated market, there will be significant opportunities in both domestic and foreign investments, especially in infrastructure build-up, promotion of the digital economy, and increased investments in knowledge products and research and development, among others, in the light of the fourth industrial revolution that is permeating the global economy. To realize the ambitious goals of the AEC, there is need for greater effort at addressing constraints to freer trade and flow of skilled labor and capital, regulatory coherence, and people-to-people contact and interaction. The AEC has some notable achievements, but there are still major challenges. For instance, there's been a major progress in the reduction of tariffs to near zero in the ASEAN, yet there is a rising trend in the use of non-tariff measures. A recent study by PIDS conducted for IRIA showed that not all ASEAN member states have clear and transparent rules on their non-tariff measures, resulting in unclear regulations that increase the transaction cost of businesses. Clearly, there is much more that needs to be done, and today's symposium will help us see the issues at closer range. And we are glad that we have here a prominent body who are very interested in ASEAN matters, and also experts who can guide us during the discussion. We will be guided by the insights and analysis of our distinguished speakers, but we need your viewpoint too in crafting a better pathway forward. The regional economy we envision requires our continued support and cooperation. I would like to encourage all of us to participate actively in this symposium, keeping in mind that our collective knowledge, wisdom, and action would be indispensable in moving to deeper economic integration and nation building. Thank you and mabuhay.